All right, so we're taking a look at Adobe Animate, the program Adobe Animate. This is for creating animation. And when you first open Adobe Animate here, you'll see that, again, there's a lot of different choices here of how you can make it look, right? There's different sizes. They call them presets, right? These are the sizes, like 1280 by 720. This is like a, you know, pretty good sized monitor, or even bigger, 1920 by 1080. 4K is really huge, 3840. This is a really, really super big file. I usually just start with the default here, but you'll see here that a lot of people work with character animation, you know, creating characters like we'll show you down here. But there's also things that are specifically made for social media, for example, right? If you're making an animation that you want to put on social media, or if you're making a video game, a lot of video games are created in Adobe Animate. You'll see that there's lots of choices, right? But you can always just start with the first one here. It's a good way to get started. I always like to take a look at what professional animators have been doing. And they have these sample files that are really useful here. Like, for example, these are and don't get intimidated when you see these, because these are done by professionals. But you can actually open up these, and they actually give you the whole Adobe Animate file so that you can actually see how it works. You can look underneath it. Like, check this out. This is pretty fancy, but this is how it looks. When I hit the play button here, you can see I get the play. It'll start the animation going. And this is what's one of the hardest things to do in animation is to create a realistic, what they call walk cycle. It's to show a humanoid figure walking. Now, obviously, this is a little exaggerated, but you can see how complicated walking really is when you think about it, because you've got your legs that are moving and your arms are also moving, but they're kind of going the opposite directions as your legs. It's a little complicated to make it really work right, but just so you can see what went into this, double-click and see what's inside here. There we go. Now, what's really happening here, this is what's kind of interesting, is that Adobe Animate uses layers, much like we learned in Photoshop, where you have layers that make up an image, right? They're kind of like onion skins that are on top of each other. And for example, I'm going to hide all the layers by clicking on this little eyeball button and then open up one at a time. So you can see here that here's one layer. This looks like, I think it's part of the leg. And then I can unhide, looks like an ankle, and then the rest of the leg. And then you can see that the animator actually animated these parts individual. Now you can see how much work really went into this as you start to look deep at it. And then we've got all these different pieces one by one that you can look at here. And you can see that, gee, this gets to be really pretty fancy as you're working through it, right? I can always change you can see how many different layers there are if you pull this up here. So I'll unhide everything, put it back to normal, and you can see that, wow, this is a lot of work that went into this. And just to give you kind of an idea, right, of what can be done, right? So let me just close this file. I'm not gonna save it, but you'll see that there are a bunch of other sample files that Adobe gives you that you can look at, just to give you an idea of the other kinds of things that people do here. Like, obviously, you can put your mouse over and just kind of see, like, someone riding a bicycle. There's an animal moving, right? There's characters that are doing different things. You can even incorporate sound. Like, this is kind of different. I'll open this one up. You can coordinate, like you see in cartoons, talking, right? So you've got mouth movement. Like, you see this little wavy file here? This is a sound file. So when I play it, you can see.
Man, this has got to be the cleanest beach I've ever seen. Not a single piece of trash. I'm starving. Hey, kid, would you drop some trash on the beach for me, please? Anything?
So you get the idea here that not only are they animating these little pieces of the mouth and the eyeballs blinking and so forth, but they're coordinating the movements with a sound file that someone recorded of a voice talking. So that's obviously the kind of thing that goes into cartooning and making cartoons. So a really good thing to do when you're first playing around with Animate is to actually look at these sample files and just kind of study them, right? To see, gee, this is what people are doing. Get an idea. Keep in mind that these aren't being done by beginners, right? These are professional level animations, but it's really inspirational to kind of see kinds of things that are being done. So this is a good thing to do just to kind of get started and kind of see what's happening.